This is Lynn from wisconsingarden.com. And now that it's going to be 90 and for the next few days, we had to get out today and pick strawberries. And thank goodness we did. We ended up with 12 pounds plus what we gave to Dean. They're just luscious. And although the other ones we picked the other day were good, these are even better. They're getting sweeter and sweeter, I think. So, not only are the berries red, Rick and I are red, both of us. We are like berry faces.
Maybe it's because we were eating so many of them.
Maybe. Well, we had to have some to keep us going.
I had a pound
energy.
Or two.
But,
somebody's got to eat them.
That's right. Exactly.
Oh, well, I guess another strawberry sundae tonight, huh?
Oh, yeah, we'll have to force ourselves.
That's a shame.
Yesterday we were blessed with a bountiful harvest of strawberries. So now we have the glorious task of going through the strawberries and getting them ready for preservation or just eating. But we also, because I pick for today and tomorrow, there are some berries that aren't quite ready yet. So this is one that, I mean, if we were pushed to eat it, we would. But this one will be even better tomorrow. So we'll be sorting out the berries as to which are ready right now, which will be ready in a day or two. And we will be cleaning them. And then it'll be a matter of washing them and either freezing them or just eating them.
So basically, after you pick a strawberry, what are you looking for? I know that you mentioned that you pick for today and for tomorrow. So you're picking berries that they're red, but they're not totally red yet. They
right.
may take another day or two to fully
mm-hmm.
mature.
Right. So the ones that look like they're ready now, you need to take the little top off. And sometimes they come off easily. Sometimes if you have a nice thumbnail, you can just pull it off. Sometimes you actually have to go in and take out the core. And then it's a matter of just putting them in the bowl, getting ready to wash them. If you find that some of the berries are damaged in a way or starting to go bad, and if it's not too bad, you just slice that part off. You look for any sign that maybe is getting too bad, which this one is, because I can see there's a brown area there. You wouldn't want, if you were going to eat it right away, it would be fine. If you were going to preserve it, it would not be fine. So I would even toss that out. So this one now is ready to be washed.
Or eaten.
Or eaten.
You know, I often wondered.
It was good.
Now, mind you, let's take a count here. I see a total of 9. Now, mind you, yesterday we had 13.
No, we had 12. We had 12.
I would think you would know that
and
for a fact. Because
I prepared some for 2 meals yesterday.
Uh-huh, because 3 are missing already. And I know I didn't have a whole one, so I'm wondering where those strawberries disappeared to. And don't blame it on our son.
They're prepared and they're in the refrigerator.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm going to go check.
Yeah, go right ahead.
Uh-huh.
All right, and then you look. I thought I saw one that had some mold on it. You're not always going to have perfect berries. This one happens to be perfect, but they aren't all like this. So it's a determination like this one. It would be perfect if you were going to do something with it right now. This one would be a very sweet one. But you can see that it has some enlarged pores, and who cares, because the cameraman is going to eat it. Here, honey.
Oh, I am. I'm lucky.
Sometimes they come out with the stem already out, which is perfect. You can just pop that right into the wash bowl. Sometimes they will have cottonwood seeds on them, which is like a dandelion tuft. So it's easier if you can pull them off. They will wash off, but they tend to be sticky. And here's one that's perfect, except one of the little corners is messed up, you want to take that off. You don't want that in there. That'll be just a point where it would be rotten. So that's it. It's just a matter of going through them all. And you would have to do this whether you went to a farm to actually pick your own, or if you go to the store and buy them, you do the same thing. You look through them, you see if there's any that are spoiled, you see if there are any that are ready to eat right now, and you see if there are any, like this one, that won't be ready for a day or two. Keep those on the counter. Don't put them in the refrigerator. They won't ripen in the refrigerator. They'll just get moldy. That would be a shame.
And this is a perfect activity to do on a day like today where we're scheduled to get a lot of rain. And good thing we picked yesterday, even though, man, that was hot.
It was hot, and some of us were dressed in black, which was not good. And some of us had to be rescued by our neighbor who was so kind and brought over a bottle of water for him and a cold cloth to put around his neck. Hopefully he has learned his lesson about dressing in black when you're going to be in the garden.
Especially when it's 80, 90 degrees.
It was hot.
I was sweating.
Mm-hmm. Well, but we're not going out tomorrow either because it's going to be in the 90s and humid.
Yeah, so the strawberries are going to have to wait for us.
Yes, they will. Well, we picked for a couple of days, so they're fine.
So how many pounds have you picked so far?
Let's see, 12 yesterday and 8, so.
Got the 20 already?
Mm-hmm.
And that's just a second picking now?
Yes. Yep.
So 200 plants doing spectacular job this year, so.
They are doing wonderfully.
Well, I suppose I should put the camera down and help you eat.
No, we're not eating. We are preparing.
Well, that's what you said yesterday, and now three are gone already, so you claim they're in the refrigerator. Okay. Well, let me help. Maybe I'll just sit here and look at them.
We got done sorting and cleaning the strawberries just before the rain started coming down, so we are now indoors. The next step is washing and very carefully moving them. They are very fragile, so the more you play with them and touch them and move them, the more bruised that they get. So you want to be very careful when you're working with strawberries. These are all the tops, or the ones that were beyond our expiration date. These will all go into the compost pile, which is wonderful. These were not quite ready yet, so those will live for another day. And just as a fun thing, we decided it would be fun to dry some of the strawberries. They are fantastic to eat, and they would make great little gifts to give to people from your garden. So first I'm going to use just canola oil spray and just give it a light, very light spray around the drying. These are from a food dryer, dehydrator. Okay. All right. And then...
And you're going to do that to each layer, right?
Each layer has to have that on there.
Okay.
And then I'm going to take the strawberry, and I'm using the bigger ones because I like the shapes of them. And I'm just going to carefully cut them in half, trying to keep them the same thickness, and place them on the dehydrator, not touching. Then these will go for about 10 hours, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
And then you'll try them and see if they... Oops, now see, this one fell all apart. Oh dear, I'll have to eat this one.
Yeah, another excuse.
But these will then I will put them in either glass jars to keep them dry or plastic bags.
So in addition to now dehydrating or drying the strawberries, you're also mm-hmm. going to freeze some, right?
I am. Now, you can freeze them whole without anything in them. That's fine. Except they have a tendency, when you do that, they're sour. They taste sour. They aren't any more sour than they are now, but for some reason, when you thaw them out and they're mushier, they just don't have the same taste. So I prefer to take my little chopper or slice them into small pieces and then either add blue agave, a stevia, or sugar to give them a little bit of sweetness, and it also helps preserve them.
Could you add honey?
Honey doesn't like to mix real well unless it's... Now, my honey, because it's getting...
Are you talking about me?
Yes, dear. Oh. It's crystallizing in here. I'd have to heat that up just to get it to be more pliable. You could use honey if you had a very thin honey, yes.
Thank you.
That would be fine. Oh. Agave is always thin, so that's fine. Some people prefer that.
And you're going to demonstrate that in a little while, too. Right?
I will, as soon as I get this part done.
Okay, so how many are you going to dry?
Oh, I think a couple trays. Now, these will shrink probably by at least half.
Oh, probably more, maybe more like two-thirds of it.
Maybe, yep. Because they're mostly water.
Yep. But when you eat a dried strawberry and you put that first one in your mouth...
It just bursts with flavor.
It's amazing. If you've never had or tasted a dried strawberry, I mean, or banana or anything dry, wow.
It's intense. You've compacted not only the water, but also the flavor. So it's powerful.
Okay. Well, I'll... wait till the next stage.
Come back until I'm done with this part.
Okay. You're not going to eat them all, are you?
You never know, unless you're here.
Okay, I better supervise this operation here. Plus, she has a knife in her hand, so I have to behave myself.
Right.
Never mess with a woman with a knife in her hand.
Smart man.
Thank you.
For now, I'm doing three trays for drying. And the most important thing to remember when you're preparing your fruit for drying is the thickness. Now, you may find that some of these are not as thick as others. You see the difference between those two. If you can, try to put all the really thin ones together and the thicker ones together. The thin ones will get done faster. And I also then try to put the thicker ones on the bottom because that's closer to the heat and the fan source. So that helps kind of even them out.
You want to talk about that particular dryer and why you ended up with this one? Because I know we started with about six other ones and we didn't like those.
Originally we had a dryer that worked very well for us. Well, originally my dad made us a dryer. That was wonderful, but it was made out of wood and it was large. And then they came out with these that are so much smaller and more portable, easier to use. The one I started with was just a heat source. It did very well. It didn't have a regulator though, or a fan. Then we found some on the internet that looked really really good, and we thought, oh, well, let's go without. Those turned out to be a disaster because they weren't engineered correctly, and the actual trays themselves would melt when you were melting or when you were drying your food. Then we found these. These are perfect. There's a variety available. Go online, go to the store, look at them. There's some exclusive Cadillac dryers, dehydrators. You really don't need that. You don't really need one of these. You can use your oven.
Or microwave.
Or microwave. I haven't done one in the microwave. Ovens, put it at 250. Just keep an eye on them. They probably aren't going to take as long as these. You just have to watch them. And again, try to put the ones that are the same thickness together.
Now, does this come with a timer, or you just keep your eye on them?
This one does come with a timer. Oh, maybe not. No, it doesn't. I just set a timer in the house, This one has a thermostat that probably will go on and off just to keep it at the same temperature, but it doesn't have a timer.
Well, you could get an external timer that you plug this unit into.
But you need to be keeping an eye on them. I mean, if you wanted to do it, you could put them on right before you went to bed and let them go overnight. They are safe enough to do that. But you want to keep an eye on it. You want to keep testing once you think it's getting close. You want to keep testing. You don't want to dry these out so hard that they've lost all their goodness. Leather hard, they say, is the best, so it's like you can still flex it a little bit. And then you need to put whatever fruit you have into something that will keep them dry. Because if you just leave them out in the air, they're going to get moisturized again. Unless, of course, you live in a desert. But
well, you put them in canning jars.
I put them in my regular old canning jars. You can put them in plastic bags. Some people put them in plastic bags in canning jars. Some people put them in plastic bags and freeze them. It's experiment and do what you think. Glass jars do fine with me. And then I do not seal them. I just put a lid on it and crank it on tight.
And then the next thing you're going to do with the leftover strawberries is you're actually going to freeze these, right?
That's right. I'm going to take these, dump them into, now these are washed, put them into a bowl. Now if I needed to, I could chop them or slice them so that they'd be a little smaller. I've got this slap chopper. Don't need to have one of these. Again, you could just slice it if you want it. These are kind of fun, kind of noisy. And what you're doing, obviously, is making them into smaller pieces. And it's up to you how small you want it. And if you want it never to see the shape of a strawberry, then you just don't do it. You do it longer. If you want some chunks in there, then you don't do it as much.
What if you oysterize this and actually got a liquid?
You could do that. You can make a fruit leather. That's what a fruit leather would be if you were drying it.
And I think we have a video up and running from a couple of years ago of making strawberry leather.
We do. If you made, that would be more like a sauce. You would be making a like a strawberry sauce.
For a banana split.
As they freeze, they do get softer. They lose their shape and their texture. So even if you had something like this, which I'm going to add a little bit of sugar to, this will be more of a sauce when it unfreezes. So
how much sugar?
You have to taste it.
Oh, could I do that?
How did I know you would want to do that?
Well, I figure you ate the last three quarts. I should get a.
Oh, I did not. They are in the refrigerator.
You keep saying that, and every time I open the refrigerator, there's nothing there.
Uh-huh. All right, now you need a spoon because I don't want your hands in here.
Okay, I'll go get a spoon.
Thank you. Now, which spoon do you think the cameraman will take?
You mean, which spoon will you give me?
You can have the big one.
Oh, sure.
All right, bring your mouth over here.
I would say that's perfect.
Plenty, yes.
Yeah.
And then you just take them. Now, if you wanted to keep some of this for eating right now, that would be fine. These will last probably a couple of days in your refrigerator. When these freeze, they're going to get bigger. When you freeze things, they enlarge.
So you don't fill it all the way to the top.
So leave some headroom. That's called a headroom.
Okay.
Be sure to wash your containers before you use them. And then those go right in the freezer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right. Okay, sure.
For real.
Yeah.
putting it on medium. And make sure that the vent is open so as much air can flow through as possible. That's what helps it dry. I'll check these in about 8 hours and see what they're like.
Okay, and then we'll finish this video.
Oh, I thought you were going to say you were going to finish eating them all by then.
No, I'm sure you'll beat me to them.
We have to taste test.
Yeah, well, do you have to taste test all of them?
No, not all of them. Each layer.
Uh-huh, yeah.
10 hours has passed. This is how they look now. Quite different from when we put them out. This was the rack that was closest to the bottom. So this one is more done at this point than the others. This one was in the middle, but it had the thicker. And this one was on top, and these had the thinner pieces. So some of them are done now, some are not. Just trying them.
See, that's where they go. That's where they end up, I keep telling you. Mm-hmm. Now I have witnesses.
They have a little crunch to them, the ones that are the driest.
You mean the ones that are left?
I have not eaten any of these. You had one. But that's how much they
shrink. Would you say
that
one more time, please?
You had one.
I have not. What?
I will just ate this one.
Just that one, huh?
Okay. But you can see, I'm not going to be eating any more. These are for winter.
Yeah, right.
This one I'm claiming is done. It's kind of leathery, so I'm going to claim that's done. These are not. And I would turn them all over. This one's done. And you can hear them clinking in there.
It's probably all that will be left by tomorrow morning. She'll be sneaking out into the kitchen tonight. She'll blame it on Sky.
But the flavor is intense. Just ignore him. The flavor is intense. And you have to be careful because they do fall down in between now as they dry.
Kind of like picking up pebbles on a beach.
Mm-hmm. I have a tendency to cook them too long or dry them too long.
Oh, you set a timer.
I did. Mm-hmm. But I mean, these are perfect. So right now I'll do some combining and then they'll have to go back out into the dryer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, right.
They will. Okay. Okay. Bye-bye.
Yes. Say goodbye to them because they aren't going to be here very long. I'm keeping an eye on you.
My eye on you.
Mm-hmm. I have witnesses.
Where are they?
They're all watching right now. Each one is going to call me and contact me and let me know. They are my witness.
We ended up with these for our freezer, and this one, it's not quite full. We'll keep that on hand for us to put on our ice cream, in addition to a couple more fresh ones that are in the refrigerator.
Uh-huh.
For later.
Yeah, right.
If you enjoyed the strawberry video, please give us a thumbs up. We'd love to hear from you. And if you'd like to subscribe, we'd love that too.
From Lynn's Strawberry Patch to yours.
Thanks for watching. Bye for now.
So am I ever really going to eat one of these?
Not a whole one.
Oh.